preparation of abutment teeth. After surgery, periodontal treatment, and any endodontic treatment of the involved arch, the abutment teeth may be prepared to provide support, stabilization, bracing, and retention for the partial denture. Abutment preparations fall into one of the following categories. 1. Teeth that are to be used in their present condition. Teeth to be used in their present condition may be unrestored, or have limited restorations, that are of no consequence to the design of the partial. 2. Teeth that require minimal restorations may be used, but allowance must be made for tooth reduction of the tooth to obtain rest seats, etc. The restoration should not be compromised by the placement of RPD preparations. 3. Teeth that require fixed restoration, that is, a surveyed crown. Cast crown restorations should be placed under certain circumstances. Of course, most if not all, endodontically treated posterior teeth require full coverage restorations. In other cases, the tooth may require a casting due to a large existing restoration, which, if lost, would jeopardize the serviceability of the RPD. Additionally, teeth which cannot be made to have correct contours or anesthetic abutments should be considered for surveyed crowns. In many cases, it is wise to prepare surveyed crowns when placing fixed restorations in any event. Abutments selected for use should be periodontally sound, caries-free, and asymptomatic. The dental surveyor is used to ensure that the surveyed crown is acceptable in terms of guiding planes, retention, and rest seat preparation prior to cementation. Therefore, planning the surveyed crown requires that the design of the RPD be established and recorded. The restoration of choice remains the full gold crown, but porcelain veneered crowns may be used provided that the porcelain used is glazed, or if the retentive element can be placed on a metallic portion of the casting.
Use of the isolated abutment is somewhat controversial. Ideally, the isolated abutment will be splinted to a nearby tooth. Other options for the isolated abutment are to use it as a normal abutment, as an overdenture abutment, or to extract the tooth.
Splinting is an option for teeth weakened by bone loss. Splinting effectively creates a multi-rooted tooth with a better prognosis and lifespan, provided that patient oral hygiene can be accomplished. Splinting is not used to support a tooth with an otherwise hopeless prognosis. Anterior modification spaces are best restored with fixed restorations. Anterior modifications will often dictate the path of insertion, invade the tongue space, and create an unstable cantilever that causes the RPD to rock. The sequence of tooth preparation involves preparation of guiding planes, axial recontouring, and retentive areas, followed by an impression to verify that the contours are correct. Once verified, rest seats may be prepared. If retention areas need to be prepared, it is usually a good idea to verify that retention is attainable by preparing the retention on the diagnostic cast first, verifying that the proposed path will permit it. If such a preparation may be verified on the stone cast, then the preparation may proceed in the mouth. Recall the preparation designs for guiding planes and rest seats. Axial walls, particularly on the distal of premolars and the mesial of molars, should be adjusted to allow correct placement of circumferential clasps.
The following slides describe preparations for rest seats and guiding planes commonly used. It is a good idea, particularly for the novice, to prepare these on a stone cast with a surveyor cutting tool. For the tooth preparation exercise, please use your dentiform. Initially, survey the dentiform. Draw the height of contour. Make the necessary guiding planes, axial contours, retentive areas and rest seat preparations, as shown in the illustrations.